Hard-fought game. You know, Black Hills is playing really well. Our girls, you know, we challenged them all week that we need to improve in some areas, and we certainly did that on Saturday and came up with some big plays and was able to make enough to get a victory against Black Hills.
Then looking ahead to this week, this is a second go around with MSU Denver and Colorado Christian. What are going to kind of be the keys to this weekend?
Well, you know, Metro historically has always been really physical, great rebounding team. They played us tough, especially when we go there. And so we've got to be ready for them and no letdowns from us. I think that's the big thing. You know, we kind of talked about the big game after the big game. And, you know, we've got to come out with the same intensity and the same focus for this weekend and be able to get two road victories.
Questions?
Savannah, I know Coach has talked a lot, you know, ever since he got here. It takes a year to kind of get into the flow of this program. And I mean, you're probably the best example of that is, you know, last year it was flashes. This year, the last 2 or 3 weeks, what has clicked from last year?
I think just kind of honing into my role on the team and helping us, you know, make sure we execute things offensively and just like, playing solid defense and things like that, honing in on my role and just kind of helping us achieve our big goal this year, and seeing where I fit into that has really helped.
I know there's so many plays and so many things you've got to kind of get used to coming from another program. And I know, you know, last year everybody's head was just like exploding, I'm sure. Was it just a matter of, okay, now a light bulb has come on and I understand?
I think just kind of getting used to playing with new people, seeing where I fit in with that, it really just kind of took more time for me. But, I think I've definitely figured it out.
Let's say it looks like just a confidence factor. You know, last year there were times it's like take the shot and it's like, no, I'm gonna. Now it's you want the ball, it looks like, when you're in there.
Yeah, I guess just like trying to figure out what my strengths are offensively and seeing how I can help our team succeed in that way. I definitely think more confident with that.
So Kai, what is last week, you know, strange week with a Monday and a Saturday game, obviously, but kind of building some momentum on this team right now, you feel?
Just all week practicing?
All week with practice and then kind of building for the rest of the season. You guys just kind of took another step.
Oh, yes, for sure. I think especially defensively, that's the defense. Saturday's defense is a defense we can play all the time, and we are just intense and tough, and it was really fun, and I think we can do that all the time, and we proved it to ourselves. We showed ourselves and Coach and the whole rest of the conference that, like, that's that we can be that tough defense and stuff. And so, like you said, hopefully we can keep building on that. Don't take any steps backwards. It'll be a good spot.
Coach, it looks like, you know, Kelsey is one of those players who can play inside, she can play outside. She's really looks like she's really working harder to be that post presence and giving Sierra a little bit of help in there too. Is kind of just a little matchup thing you're seeing a little bit more now?
Yeah, well, I think it depends on how they guard her. You know, a lot of times they're starting to put smaller people on her. So, you know, that's definitely something that we can capitalize on. And I think she realizes that too. And, you know, just her too filling in that role and getting comfortable and playing with her back to the basket. We want her to be able to take those shots, and she's starting to do that. So, you know, you add that to her perimeter shooting, and, you know, it just makes it a little bit harder for teams to guard.
Coach Kylyn mentioned defense. Over the last six games, you guys haven't allowed double digits and assists as a team. Is that something you feel like you guys can hang your hat on, is just getting into the passing lanes, getting into steals, and kind of keeping a man ball?
Yeah, I mean, we definitely want to keep our defense first and foremost at the front of what we do. You know, we practice that every day. We emphasize it. And, you know, when you have a bad night shooting, your defense is going to keep you in the ball game, and that's proven, you know, in the years past and this year too, that, you know, even though we have a poor game offensively, we can still stick with some teams. And so we want to continue to do that and just really force teams into taking bad shots and you know, lower their shooting percentages down. And when we're able to do that, you know, it helps us at the end of the game, and hopefully it equates to victories for us.
When you draw an assignment like you did Saturday against Winsis, I know you and Sophie kind of traded off on her. Does that just kind of give you just a little more of a jolt of adrenaline going, you know, this is, they think I can do this? And
oh, yeah, for sure. All week and even up game day, I had all my teammates telling me, like, you got it. Like, this is you. This is what we need you for. Like, this is your role, all that kind of stuff. And I just took it and was happy to be that person for us, and I just went all in. I was like, from the start, you know, I'm gonna show her what she's gonna have to deal with for 40 minutes. And Sophie did an amazing job too. And yeah, my teammates just always were super excited. Like all week, they're just saying, like, that's you, Winchester defense, you know, stuff like getting me excited about it. And it's hard not to be excited to have such a good support system behind you like that. So.
Well, and a lot of times when players get that, their offense might dip. You just kind of took it the opposite. It just, mm-hmm. It really did fuel your offense a little bit.
Yeah, no, coach always says that defense fuels our offense, and I think that's exactly what happened for me, so it was awesome.
I know individual accolades probably aren't as important as team stuff, but does that kind of maybe motivate you guys getting somebody to win deep put arm active as a player of the week? Does that make you guys kind of maybe want to push for it and have somebody else get it every week, or is that kind of team goal you guys have?
Well, I think that we always want to strive to have good defense in general as a team. I think getting like individual accolades like Kelsey this past weekend just makes us proud of our teammates, and knowing that we're helping support them and helping support each other to achieve our overarching goals.
All right, question of the week. What's your favorite sports movie? I don't think we've done that one yet.
Yeah, but
that's I'd have to go with Hoosiers. Hoosiers. Hoosiers is a good one, yeah.
Does Talladega Nights count? Semi-pro? No, I'm just kidding. Big Will Ferrell fan.
I don't know, just the one that comes to mind was one that our coach had us watch earlier this season. It's called Greater, and it's on like Netflix or something. It's a football movie, so it's a good one.
Go watch it.
It's pretty good.
Was it?
Yeah.
It's really good, yeah. True story.